Hi everybody, welcome back to another awesome day, another awesome vlog. I'm back at my really cool, quaint little cemetery that I like to come to. It's so peaceful and quiet. So anytime I want to film my Lakers updates, this is where I try to come. I wanted to give you guys a little peek at this beautiful graveyard that I always come to. I usually only show one area of it, so I thought I would just give you a quick view. As you can see, it's not very big. It's just a nice, small, quaint little graveyard over here. And I just really love coming here because it's always so quiet and peaceful. Usually there aren't even very many people here. Sometimes I don't even see anyone. But I thought at least I would share with you so you could see a little bit of the view that I get every time I come here to talk to you guys about the Lakers. Luckily the rain has stopped, so I was able to come out today. The cemetery isn't too flooded, so here I am, ready to do a Lakers update for you. Let's get started. So this update isn't going to be very long because we've actually had a break in games lately, and there isn't going to be another NBA game until February 21st, which is next Thursday, so almost a week away. That is because, of course, this weekend is the NBA All-Star weekend, and all of the teams have kind of taken a break, and there aren't going to be any games going on this weekend or for the first part of next week. So because of that, the Lakers haven't really played much. Since my last update, the Lakers did have a game against the 76ers. The 76ers were at home, so it was an away game for the Lakers. The first quarter and even the second quarter, the Lakers were amazing. We actually had the lead for quite some time. Kuzma scored the most points in any first quarter in any game ever played at home against the 76ers. He scored 23 points in the first quarter alone. He played so amazing, he ended up scoring a total of 38 points throughout the game. It's not his highest, of course, his highest was 41 points, but this was a really, really close second. Also, our new player, Reggie Bullock, was able to play throughout the entire game, and he has proven to be a great asset to the Lakers. Reggie Bullock was traded to the Lakers from the Pistons for Svi Mykhailiou. So Svi Mykhailiou is no longer on the Lakers, but Reggie Bullock is amazing. He was able to shoot three-pointers in this game and the following game. Unfortunately, against the 76ers, we lost. We weren't able to pull out a win, but the Lakers played so great. It's starting to look like LeBron is back to his full potential, or getting there anyway, and the Lakers are starting to play great. But the 76ers are an amazing team. They ended up coming back in the end and winning the game. I will tell you though that I'm really looking forward to Reggie Bullock and watching him play more often with the Lakers once they get to know each other and get to figure out their groove. I think that they are going to be amazing. I think that Reggie Bullock was a great choice, and I think that this is going to be a perfect fit. Our other new player is Michael Muscala. He was traded for Beasley and Zubac. Mike Muscala has only played very, very little since he was traded to the Lakers, and he appears to be a great shooter. He has made a couple of three-point shots, but he really has only been in for a few minutes since he came to the Lakers. Mike Muscala is 27 years old, and he's been playing in the NBA for 5 years. He is a forward and a center, and he has played for the Hawks and the 76ers. So we're excited to have him. I haven't really seen him much, like I said, but I'm hoping that he will get out there, learn to play with the Lakers, show us what he's got and what he's worth, and hopefully it will be a good trade. I'm sure that the Lakers know what they're doing. Magic Johnson really is trying to put together the dream team again, and I'm hopeful that this will be a good fit. Since my last update, one of the most amazing things happened. It was the game with the Boston Celtics. At the end of the fourth quarter, they were tied, so they went into overtime. Overtime was incredible, back and forth as well. The Lakers, with 11 seconds left, were down by 1 point. The ball was inbound to Ingram, who went for the basket. He went straight to the hoop and tried to make the basket, but it was blocked by one of the Celtics players. The ball was then fumbled around a bit, and Chandler was able to bat it out enough to Rajon Rondo, who, with only 4 seconds left, grabbed the ball, made the shot, and at the buzzer, it went in. We won the game by 1 point, and it was such an amazing celebration. It was like finally the Lakers had come together, worked together, won a game. It was so incredible. I loved it. Bill loved it. It was amazing to come to work the next day and talk to my friend about it as well because she had been watching it. It was so, so great. I'm just hopeful that the Lakers can really get it together. We have some new players now that need to learn how to play together with all of our Lakers players that are currently on the team that have just started to come back from all of their illnesses and injuries. But I'm very, very hopeful that this is going to be a strong Laker team. I hope that this weekend you guys will be checking out the NBA All-Star Game and all of the fun activities that go on this weekend, because I know I will be. And I look forward to coming back with another update, but it's going to be a little while because the games don't even start until Thursday the 21st. So in the meantime, don't forget to smash the thumbs up button, don't forget to subscribe, and don't forget to check back soon for Lakers updates and announcements.